greetings. Salutations. Let me turn the music down. Where's the music? There's the music. Hello, welcome back to Inktober 2023, day 10. The good news is, I'm finally going to be in the double digits. And after today, I mean, we're not going to talk about that pesky little 31 down there. But after today, I'm basically a third of my way through the month. And that's pretty exciting. So welcome in anybody who's live or you're watching on the replay. I appreciate your time. As always, appreciate your support for me and what I do. If you're unfamiliar, I'm going through Inktober. This is year 5 for me. I've done Inktober multiple years. However, notably different this year. This is my first time to embark on the official prompt list from the fine folks that run Inktober. I've actually gone with Patreon-submitted prompts for the last several years. So a little bit more custom, a little bit more unique. But this year, I'm just going straight up. I'm also doing everything digitally. So I have gone traditional for the last several years, and I'm like, you know what? I want to give myself a little bit of a break because I am a little bit more comfortable with digital. I can make it look a little bit better. I have a little bit more tools at my disposal. So here we are. Today's prompt is fortune. I've got an idea, and my idea already sounds labor-intensive. So, yes, I have switched off the challenges for today because I'm like, I feel like this is going to run long and I just don't want to deal with it today. So, redeems are off today. You can still transform me if you wish, but no art challenges for today. Also, before we get into the creative process of today, another reminder, I am running a promo on my shop all month long. So, if you type in !! shop in the chat, that will give you the link directly to my store, where I have hundreds of things that I sell. Waterproof, weatherproof stickers, art prints, original works of art, and books. I've published 3 books as of this date. I'm working on a 4th. So, any order, any dollar amount, any subject matter, any genre, anything will get you a Count Hinkula exclusive promo sticker, which is my persona for the spooky season. These are limited to 40. They are hand-numbered on the back. I am down 10, so that means I have 30 remaining. So don't sleep on it. If you know you want to grab one, grab one. People have voiced regret in missing previous years. So I can only do so much. I can only do so much and tell you, hey, these are limited. This is every year annual tradition. You miss it, you miss it. But yeah, check it out. Check out my shop. Appreciate all the support and love. Another thing I wanted to show, I didn't get to show you guys yesterday the final presentation of the drawing because I drew the elements separate, but I didn't quite thread it together because I was going to wait to frame it up. So this was the final result of yesterday's Inktober prompt, which was bounce. Something else that's kind of funny is when I was drawing this, I kind of assume, you know, this is a little girl and she's bouncing on this happy slime, right? This is like that moment right as she's coming back down. Like she's jumped up, she's coming back down. After this has lived on the internet for the last, 12 hours or so, I think a lot of people assume this little girl was, like, walking, and then she was surprised. Like, she's jumped back because, oh my goodness, the ground has a face. Which I don't know if I am bothered by. I think either way works because it's still, like, she's shocked. If that's how you're perceiving the image, that she's like surprised and startled and she's jumping back because, oh my goodness, she's accidentally walked onto this creature, it's still a bounce, so it still works. So either interpretation is perfectly fine with me. Also, I drew this. Hey, I drew this. So yesterday, after the stream, I was super burnt out. As I have been all month and for some time. So, and I apologize, I have some M&Ms with me. I went and bought some M&Ms this morning. I was super burnt out. I'm still burnt out. I'm heavily burnt out. I'm tired. I'm exhausted. And when I finished up Inktober yesterday, I needed to get back to work. I needed to get back to work. Working on commissions and Pro Gamers Guide spreads. I was so burnt. I didn't want to do anything. And the problem is, The problem is, what up? What up, Goddess of D's? The problem is, art for me, art is my job. Art is my hobby. Art is my escapism. Art is everything for me. And so it's kind of ironic that it's like, I do not want to work on any of the things I need to work on, but I still want to draw because I want to create. So, I mean, I just sat here and mindlessly worked on this. I don't know who it is. It's nobody. There's bits and pieces that are pulled from Google search results, but it's not anybody. It's random. I'm really happy with it, though. Thank you. I think it's beautiful, too. I think it's a great piece of art. So I went ahead when I was done with it, and I tossed it up on TeePublic, and I tossed it up on Redbubble. So I'll drop those links in the chat as well if anybody wants to check them out. Remember, this is literally my only source of income is this. So there you go. If you like to grab it on a shirt, a hoodie, a coaster, a shower curtain, a pillowcase, a reusable bag, pencil pouch, laptop sleeve, cell phone case, anything, really anything. Sticker, bang it. It's on there. And I've also, yesterday, after the stream, I uploaded finally the day 3 prompt, which was path. So now everything's up. Everything's up now. Got it legit broke today. My bank account is negative $61 as of this morning. So I totally understand. Totally understand. So it's all up. I'm happy to say if you go to my Redbubble or my TeePublic, all 9 Inktober prompts are all on there. So if you want to grab something, if you're digging the art, would make a nice gift. So it's all up there. So everything's up, including this. All right, go away. So today's prompt is fortune. I have an idea, so we'll see. We're gonna start drawing. We're gonna start brainstorming and see what we come up with. And thank you guys for hanging out with me. I am on dog listen again. I've got my old dog outside. I went and got him a massive comical sized bone for him to gnaw on. Because. So my thoughts on fortune, this is what I'm thinking. This is definitely another example of Kevin wanting to torture himself. So, but when I think of fortune, right, we're remaining in the fantasy setting, right? I'm thinking a bunch of coins, like stacks of coins, maybe like a piece of parchment. You can't see what I'm doing. Piece of parchment. So I'm thinking like a crop shot of like a table. Okay, this is my thought for today. My thought for today is a shot of the table. Maybe this is a map. Maybe this is that map that the map maker was working on, huh? Tied in, a little bit of a narrative. Put a little coin on the map. Blah, blah, blah. We got dot, 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 X, whatever. Coin. But see, these stacks of coins, that's what's going to absolutely drive me crazy. It's going to drive me crazy. So this is what I'm thinking about. I went two ways when you said that. Fortune telling or Scrooge pool of gold. I didn't even think of fortune in terms of like a fortune teller. That's a pretty good perception, though. Hopefully somebody else does something like that. Catherine's here. Oh, I was wondering which way, too. Could be future-y. I didn't think of that at all. Maybe because money's on my mind. My mind's on my money and my money's on my mind. So that's what I'm thinking. This is also the very first day of Inktober in which I have turned off the drawing challenge redeems. I think I have endured enough. I'll probably leave them off, to be honest. To the great dismay of Bobo Laveau. But, yeah, we're gonna leave those off. Got too much going on, alright? Too much going on. I need a break. What does the map look like? I need a refresher. Because I kind of like the idea of this being a tie-in to the other piece. And I hope everybody's doing wonderful today. Today I really do need to get back to work. And you stop messing around. I am overdue on my Pro Gamer's Guide spread that I started last week. Need to get to work on that. Reed!
Hi, Kevin.
Reed is here. Thank you for the 25 bits, Reed. How are you? How's it going, Reed? So we're gonna have like a fortress here. Dot, 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 dot. On this side, we had a bunch of trees. There's like a forest going on. And there's an X here. Okay. I'm planning a Kinder Rodeo. Kinder Rodeo. That's fun. About to go beg for some yardsticks from Home Depot. Well, yeah, good luck. Good luck. Hope Castle dropping off truck for preventative maintenance and waiting for my ride back to warehouse. Doesn't that sound fun? Doesn't that sound absolutely great? Man, this is going to be miserable. Drawing all these coins, this is going to be miserable. What is a way I can make this easier on myself? I could use some ellipse tools. I can use the ellipse tool and then copy paste. I can't do it too much though, because you're going to notice. If it's too obvious. It can't be too obvious. People pick up on that, especially other artists. I can do a copy and paste of a couple stacks, but not a ton. You can't do it too much. Smaug's Den, no, we're not doing any fan art. No fan art. Nope. No Smaug. Covered in a dragon? Nah. I don't know if there's dragons in my story. There might be. Maybe. Goddess of D's, you should draw a fortune cookie on the coin top you see. Interesting idea. I'll think about it. I do want one of these coins laying like this. I want a coin on this map like this. I know I want that. Maybe two coins down like that. And another coin here, going behind the piece of paper. Maybe a short stack of coins. Then you combine both prompt ideas, you say. Is that a future image of your Powerball winnings? Man, I wish. Reed, make all the difference in the world right now. I mean, I guess everybody, literally everybody could say that. Would change my entire life right now. Add some gems, maybe. Add some crystals and things. Not a bad idea.
Looks so good.
Redropping the panda alarm. I thought panda was here for a second. I thought for a second panda was here. It's early for panda. And then the background will just be black. So this is like a table. So I need to make sure I draw these items separate again, because there'll probably be a little bit of finagling when it comes to the final presentation. Of course. Anybody want to take a guess on how many hours it's going to take me to draw this? (laughs) 7.325. Well, the record is 5 so far. The River Elf Queen took me 5 hours. I gave her very elaborate jewelry, which I was really proud of. So there's a little tear here, and then there's another tear. I'm looking at the other map that I drew. There's a tear here. You remember? I remember. So I took a peek at the metrics on the Redbubble shop and the TeePublic shop just to see if the new designs that I'm uploading daily are resonating with anybody, if they're favoriting the artwork or anything, and they're not moving. It's kind of disappointing. Also kind of the story of my life. The one that has the most action is the drip, the water dripping off the leaves. It has 7 favorites on Redbubble, which is nice. Nothing has sold. I haven't sold a single thing. But just kind of, you know, interesting metrics. Should I put a knife? Should I put a dagger in the map? I think maybe I should. That'd be kind of cool, huh? And I could block some of these coins. I could block some of these coins. Thank you for the hugs. Yeah, I told someone the other day who was like, you know, hey, Kevin, how's it going? I'm like, awful. Absolutely miserable. Absolutely miserable. Thank you for asking me. But we were talking about, they were trying to help, as most of my friends do. Bubble of O, what's going on? Or you could draw the coins that decide that, to add that. Or you could draw the, or you could draw the coins, then decide to add the dagger. I mean, I guess I could do that. Turn him off, Bobo. I think I finally hit. I was like, you know what? Redeems are off. they'll probably stay off for the rest of the Inktober drawings. Sorry. I know that really only affects you. I know. Just need a little bit of a break. I need to do what I can to kind of scale down the times of these streams. They're eating up a big chunk of my day, and I can't.
We'll just put one in here by the castle.
Yes, don't go around altering liable after
yep.
Franklin Gold. Yes, I think so. Yes,
the joyfulness is over, unfortunately. The joyfulness is over. What was I saying? So I was talking about with my friend, talking about he was trying to help, giving me a bunch of ideas, and it's. I try not to be. What's the word? I try not to be, like, abrasive to people's ideas and suggestions, but the fact of the matter is I've done them all. And so it's like, we went through the whole, have you tried this? Yes. Have you tried this? Yes. Have you tried this? Yes. So we did that whole rigmarole the other night. Yes, I've done that. But I made a comment, and I was like, dang, that is kind of a accurate comment, and I felt kind of sad after I said it. I said, I feel like the harder I try, the worse I'm off. It's kind of a sad thing to say. But that's true. I feel like the harder I try, the worse I'm off. So maybe the lesson is to not try. Are you breaking up with me? Are you trying the it's me? It's me, though. It really is me. Pro tip, Kevin does not want your ideas or suggestions. It's true. Goddess of D's. Yeah, no, I don't care if you take my ideas or not. I just make them because I cannot make them. Doesn't look the same. Don't like it. Erase. Like, I know when I was trying to grow as a streamer and I was forcing it, I came across as desperate and nobody wanted it. Yeah, exactly. Nobody wants to support someone who's negative Nancy. I mean, I feel bad too. I feel bad all the time. I'm like, I hate this. But it's also like, if you don't talk about it, nobody knows about it. The one closer. Can I rotate this drawing? I need to rotate my other drawing so I can see the map from his perspective. There we go. When I have fun in stream, it's still a 50-50 or less, but at least I'm enjoying it. Yeah, I had an artist. I had another artist who I've gotten to know over the last year at the convention circuits. We've run into each other time and time and time again out at events. And she sent me a message about a show the other night on X. On X? I hate saying X. But it was like, hey, Kevin, are you doing this show? And I was like, nope, couldn't get in. And I have no money to book any tables. And she was taken aback. She's like, really? I was like, no. I was like, I'm absolutely broke. And we went into this whole conversation, and she was like, Kevin, I thought you were one of the most successful artists in the area. I was like, yeah, that's the problem. Fake it till you keep faking it. But I'm actually more bummed that I'm not getting any leads on these job applications. That's really aggravating me. I'm like, nothing? No interviews at all? No responses at all? Come on. Carlos is here. What's up, Carlos? Carlos, nice to see you streaming last night, man. We missed our Carlos time. Carlos is claiming, guys. Carlos is claiming that he is back to live streaming regularly. I'm not quite ready to give you the full Hinkle promotion yet. You do one more, and then I'll say Carlos is back. Carlos is back in business. You do one more, you're back in business. Anybody can just do one. let's see. The job market has turned to crap. People don't do the polite things anymore. Yeah, I've heard a lot of stuff about how bad the job market is, and I can agree. It's not good right now. I haven't applied for anything in the last couple days because I'm just so burnt. But I'm about... when we get to November time, if I still don't have anything, that is when your boy Kevin will be hitting the old retail again. Don't call it a comeback. I'll drive around my local areas and find something. Back on that minimum wage grind. Like a true artist. Full circle. I don't know what these are supposed to be. Rocks? Tombstones? Next Monday, friend? Okay. All right, Carlos. Ew, no. I gotta do it, man. Gotta do it. Gotta do it. All right, there's two trees. I'm really trying to copy this map I did. There's two trees like this. So the guy that created Inktober, Jake, I think his name's Jake Parker. He's on social media. He's everywhere. And he's been drawing each day too. And his is 100% like a narrative. And it's amazing. It is incredible. Because he's like, he just goes from prompt to prompt to prompt. And it's one cohesive story and you can follow it. Like little guys like going down underground. Like sewer, and then he comes across a toad monster, and then the toad monster like attacks him by jumping on him, so it's like bouncing. It's like crazy. It's like, wow. Incredible. I think it was maybe last year, it could have been the year before, but there's another artist I follow. He's up in Canada, and he did an entire graphic novel for Inktober. An entire graphic novel. He did a page a day. And, I mean, it was incredible, and he also fully admitted that it literally killed him. And it was exhausting, but he did it, and he was proud of it. And when Inktober ended, he's... opened up the pre-orders for his comic. But I was like, geez, man. A page a day. Like full graphic novel, not like a webcomic. Like full graphic novel. Crazy. Bubba says, there you go. The Inktober of PGG3. Yeah, each day we tie an Inktober prompt to an exciting lesson on taxes. This goes... cool. All right, let's put a little crystal. See, now this is very relevant to my original comic idea. Crystals. The essences. Here is the map to all the places you can submit your tax returns. Love it. Now you're thinking. Now you're thinking. Now you're using your old noodle. How did it feel to live stream, Carlos? I assume you're at work. May I assume you're at work? How did it feel to be back in the saddle, man? I'm at work. Felt great? That's good. Good deal, man. Good deal. Yeah, I didn't do anything I was supposed to do yesterday after stream. Nothing. I mean, I saved out the artwork from Inktober, and I put it on social, and I put it on my print-on-demand shops, but, like, I didn't do anything else after that. Too burnt. Too tired. I did draw some women while I was avoiding everything else, because I wanted to draw. It's a really weird place to be. I enjoy drawing a lot, and it helps me. Also my job. It's also my hobby. It's also my escapism. So it's like, oh, I want to draw. I just don't want to draw any of the things I'm supposed to draw. I just don't want to draw anything I'm supposed to draw. I tried. Carlos is really liking the switch to OBS for software. I got to add some more fun stuff later. So what are the big differences, man? Because I'm on Streamlabs. What's the difference? What's the big deal? Tell me the deal. Too much pressure on one eye. That's probably it. I suggest being snarky as a fine hobby. Mm. I want this X to feel like it's in perspective. Streamlabs was killing my CPU real hard. I don't really have that issue. Not that I know of, but I also have a new computer. When it's not overheating and being stupid. But that was not a problem with the computer. That was a problem with my liquid air cooling unit. Which apparently was really good until it wasn't. But it's been fine ever since I replaced it with a traditional cooling unit with the fans. Let the copy and pasting commence. There will be a decent chunk of that, I promise you. On this one, for sure. We're still not on the final art, by the way. We will get there. This is on the map, I think. OBS feels a little more customizable, although it's harder to set things up, but there's more freedom. It chugs real hard, especially if I run the webcam and the art camera, but it's super smooth on OBS now. Well, good. That's good. Is there a sound difference with your new cooling? No. I like how quiet my liquid cooling is. No, there's no difference. It doesn't. I mean, most of the time I have headphones on anyway. I'll probably switch at some point because I feel like that's what I'm supposed to do. Like, I really don't have any issues with Streamlabs, but I feel like that's what I'm supposed to do. I feel like the cool kids use OBS, right? Which of course is ironic because I used to use Streamlabs, and like that the cool kids were using I used to use StreamYard, and the cool kids were using Streamlabs. I'm like, okay. Like, I'm never on the right thing at the right time. The pros, the professors. Is the cool kids Mr. Barber? Benjamin Barber? He uses StreamYard. Actually. He's another one of those folks that I'm like, how on God's green earth are you doing everything that you're doing? Like, he is... Oops, I should probably not do that yet. He's running like 15 different social media accounts for different companies and brands and associations, and it's like insane. And I do a lot. So is mine. I upgrade everything but the motherboard. I also stream gaming, so I don't know how they compare. Because he's not trying as hard. I think he is. You don't think he is? Or is that a subtle commentary on the type of content he's creating? I mean, all accounts show me he's trying. Our dear friend Benjamin J. Barber. I don't know if his middle name is J, but he strikes me as someone who have middle name J. He seems like a J. No, have you seen him make his overlays in like 5 minutes on the fly, and the music selection is the first thing? Oh, that's true. I guess you're right. It is a lot of very, very quick very, what's the word, like, yeah, what am I trying to say? Like, you grab the stuff from Shutterstock, right? Like, Shutterstock B-roll footage, Shutterstock generic image of people walking. Whereas, like, I literally make every single component of everything I use. Every overlay, every ad. Everything is made. These coins are stacking up fast. Yeah, it's not the final though. It's getting there. Why is he howling? Why is that dog howling? He's got a big old bone. All right, I'll be back. Dog check. Turning out to be a beautiful day out there. He's got nothing to complain about. Not cold, sun's out. Really nice, actually. He is living the high life out there. And not the high life show that I did. He's got a massive, juicy bone, fresh water, sun's out. Got no reason to be howling out there. No reason. We've begun our 8 months of winter. Yes. Today's pretty nice out there. It was a little cold yesterday. How can I have so many emotes and so few dogs? Are Twitch people just cat people? That's a good question. But yeah, oh man. So yesterday it was a little chilly. He was out for most of the day, but it was chilly. He was doing the Chihuahua shiver thing. I'm like, you. So I let him back in the house at 5:30. And from 5:30 until, from 5:30 until 10 o'clock. So 5 hours. I had to fully mop my kitchen 4 times. Due to all of his dog mess. It really is that bad. I'm not exaggerating. It is that bad. This morning, so obviously he sleeps inside. He's an indoor dog. This morning I woke up. I wake up at 5:45. Got up, fully mopped the kitchen. It was an absolute war zone, as it is every single morning. Everywhere, all over the place. Mopped up the kitchen. Made breakfast. Sat down to eat breakfast. Turned around. Went again all over the kitchen. Two mops within the first hour of me being awake for the day. We're sadly very much at a point where we, major apologies to all the pet lovers out. We're at a end of life conversation is where we're at, because this is unsustainable and it's way too hard on me. Way too hard on me. I don't know if I could deal with that. Yeah, Carlos, it's bad, Carlos. It's bad. I clean up all the dog mess. I'm talking all of it. Pee, poop, vomit, like all of it. I clean it up from that dog when he's inside 8 to 15 times a day, every day, and I've done it for a year. Every day. Every day, every single day. I'm literally out of my mind. That's also part of my extreme exhaustion and burnout. That I've been dealing with this dumb dog. Who's just old. He's just old. He can't hold anything anymore. Can't control himself anymore. Doesn't like to go outside. So he's leashed up outside because I just can't. I can't keep doing this. So we are definitely at that point where we need to have that serious conversation about into life, because it's just not it's not sustainable, and it's not okay for anybody to have to be dealing with this. All right, I need to move on to like real artwork now. But yeah, I guess so yeah, we have, yeah, Carlos, I understand. We've got our whole house is wood, except for the kitchen. Wood floors. So it only took like a couple months. I guess it's saying something that it actually took that long. But it took a couple of months before I was like, okay, you are hereby banned from roaming the house because you are causing extreme damages to this home. So I corralled him into the kitchen, which is where he's basically lived his life for the last 8 months, which is sad. But I can't do it. Today is beautiful, though. It was a little cold yesterday, which is why I let him in early, and of course immediately had a regret about it. But it was chilly, and the weather is getting colder, so it's like that time is limited. But it is, guys, it is bliss when he's out all day and I only have to mop like once in the morning and once at night. It is bliss. And that's so sad that that's where I'm at, where it's like, oh, I only have to clean up twice today? Huh. Huh. Is this what it's like to be in the Bahamas? Goddess of D's. So when I got divorced, we had a dog that was like that because my ex worked from home. And I worked at work. I finally had to rehome him to a no-kill shelter because I just couldn't. Yeah, it's too much. It's too much. And I am nothing if not known for having an absolutely legendary degree of patience and tolerance with everything. And I have been dealing with it myself, almost entirely myself, for an entire year. But these were old dogs. They've lived very long, happy, happy, loved lives. But, you know, end of life. And I don't want, like, can you imagine? I don't want my last years of my dogs being filled with rage and never-ending mop heads and scrubbing. Ugh. It just, like, completely kills all the good memories. It really does. Because it's that bad. It is that bad. But yeah, our other dog, we put her down. She was 19. We put her down in, I think, July? Was it July? And she was also almost entirely blind. We have one tree in our backyard. She would walk into the one tree. What's up, Ray? Dog days of Inktober. Yeah, man. So she was entirely blind. Bless her little heart. She was a sweetheart. She was also deaf. So a lot of times you'd be sitting there calling her and she would just not even move. Couldn't even hear what you were doing. But she was also having these exact same problems that he's having. But the thing is his eyesight's degrading. But he has no other... His eyesight's degrading, so he's having depth perception problems, which sometimes results in him, like, missing the step when he, like, jumps off. And it always makes me cringe, because it's, like, it looks so painful. Because he'll, like, miss a step, and he'll jump down, and he'll just, like, land on his chest, and it's like, ah, you are gonna kill yourself. But yeah. What's up, Ray? Today's prompt is Fortune Ray, which is well-timed. Well-timed, if you look at my bank account. So I'm doing a table with a map and some coins and some jewels and stuff. Did you win the lottery? Man, if I won the lottery, I would absolutely, without a shadow of a doubt, not be live. you guys, I would vanish off the face of the earth for a little bit. For a little bit. Not forever, just a little bit. How do I want to do this? Come on. Come on. That's fine. I would vanish until the money's gone. No, if I won the lottery, I would pay off. I would just pay off everything. Pay off all the credit bills. I would say pay off my student loans, but they are so close now that it doesn't matter. I think November. I think November's my last payment. The cars are paid off, so that doesn't matter. I would like to own a home one day, but I've honestly kind of given up on that ever being a reality for me in my lifetime. I don't think that's ever going to be in my lifetime. Don't let the cars hear you. Yeah, man. I'm sure there's some repairs they could use. You're absolutely right. I'm sure there's something they could have a nice little fixer up. I would absolutely take a vacation. I would take a vacation, like, with my kids, and then I would take a vacation by myself. I would take two vacations. I would be like, okay, I need to go on a vacation by myself first, and then I'm going to come back, and I will take you guys on vacation. I think that seems fair. Don't let the cars hear you. All right, let's see. Let's start this coin business here. We're gonna definitely be using some ellipse magic. 2.5. Vacation sounds nice. Maybe in 5 years. Yeah, man. My last vacation was, my last real vacation was 2018. So that was 19, 20, 21, 22. So yeah, 5 years ago. I've had other, like, time off, but, like, they're not really vacation. Like, I had, you know, that time, what was it, last January that I, like, took off? But, I mean, I did other things. Usually I do other home things. Parental responsibilities. But like real vacation, my last real vacation was when I went on that cruise in 2018. That might have been 2017. When I literally didn't have to do anything, be anywhere. Nobody relied on me for anything. Good news! One whole coin. Cruise is fun. Stuck on a boat for a week. Yeah, man. Have you ever been on a cruise? I mean, it's like, yeah, if you have a fear of water, probably not. But it's like anything you could ever want. a million and a half different games, activities, like literally water park, mini golf, plays, a skate rink, arcade, casino, swimming, endless food. Everywhere you go, people are giving you food. It's kind of insane. It's like the pinnacle of like what's the word for you don't need it? what is that word, right? Like it's more than you need. The epitome of overconsumption or something. That's not the right word. I was at the buffet most of the day and getting sunburns. Yeah. And they just walk around. People just walk around giving you more food. It's like crazy. The number of times I remember like just like sitting next to the pool and like some, you know, indulgence, that's a good word. Somebody would walk by and they'd be like, oh, excuse me. Anybody here interested in a little bit of apple pie? And you're like, what? And you just look up tray of apple pie with like vanilla ice cream. You're like, where did you come from? Oh, pardon me. Sorry for the interruption. Anyone like Some fresh apple pie just out of the oven. What? Where am I? Amazing. Happens so many times. I don't know what this means, but I'll accept it. Yeah, the cruise I went on, we went to, where did we go? Costa Maya? I think we went to Costa Maya. And we did go check out some ruins. Did a little tour of some ruins. It was 5 day? I think it was a 5 day cruise. Out of Miami. Merged all these together. Was that dangerous? Probably. Did you get bombarded with taxi people? I don't think so. We'd already like pre-booked everything. Kind of know where to go, when where to go and when to go, and people are waiting for you. I mean, it also helped that I was not with any of my family. It was just me. Me and my friends. I didn't want to go. I was like, guys, this is the last thing I need to be doing right now. I was very resistant. Very, 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 very resistant. It's like, this is the absolute last thing I need to be doing right now. I just lost my job of 16 years. I have plunged my family into financial turmoil. Everybody's stressed. Everybody's worried. What makes you think I need to leave everybody and go on a cruise? But my buddy Matthew Kay and Tommy Armstrong, they were like, Kevin, you desperately need this after what you've been through over the last couple. Which, thinking back now, thinking of what I've been through now compared to then, I was fine then. But, so they insisted. They wouldn't let me get out of it. And so they literally bought the ticket for me on the cruise. I had no reason not to. And I still had my... I feel like that looks dumb. For some reason, this bottom half of this stack of coins looks extra flat. That bottom one. It looks extra flat for some reason. Maybe I should just let it sit for a bit and go somewhere else, I think. Learn some Spanish and take a vacation to Colombia. Lots of vacations for cheap. I don't know what vacations you're looking at. Probably not. Maybe. For some reason, it feels like it's not centered. I know it is. I know it's perfectly centered. I don't know why I feel like it's not. Backyard camping vacation. Ugh. I go camping enough with the scouts. $300 cash and did a bunch of stuff and didn't spend all of it. Just don't run into any drug people, huh? Oh, easy. Easy. Man, I don't know what it is about this. It does feel extra flat. This bottom one feels flat. Look at that. Already fixed it. Without an ellipse tool, may I add. Looks like burger bottom buns. You're a burger bottom bun. You're a butt. Those drug people are choice clients. Do you have any drugs? No. But do you want to buy this pot sticker for $9.99? Man, I wish I could sell it for $10. Goddess of D's is a burger bottom bun. Burger bottom bun. Burger bottom bun. This is exciting, guys. This is day 10. I'm finally in the double digits. Do you understand? Do you have any idea what this means? Those guys are going to be so lucky. You're hungry? No, but I am glad that you seem pleased by double digits. Well, so it's a 31-day challenge. So once I finally get to double digits, I feel like I'm actually getting somewhere. So, this is the first year. This is my first year. This is my fifth year doing Inktober. Doing a piece of art every day through the entire duration of October. Black and white. Using a prompt list. But in more dire news, this is the first year I've gone into it burnt out at the beginning. Usually I hate myself like week two or three, not day one. So I'm glad that I'm in double digits, because then it means I'm like third of the way there. Carlos is hungry. Bobo says, at what day do you feel you traditionally lose your mind? Oh, so usually, in all honesty, usually days like 15 through like 23, that is the point of insanity. Because it's like you're past the halfway point, but you're not quite near the end. And the numbers don't really mean anything anymore. You know, you're not in the single digits, but you're not quite there in the upper 20s where you're close to 30. Like that like teenage number, you just lose all sense of reality. That's the bad time. That's the dark time. And did you see, hey, you beat me, I did one. You did do one. Carlos did one, everybody. Everybody, Carlos did a single prompt, but he did Linktober, which is fine. I accept that. One of these days, I'll do Linktober. Maybe when I'm nice and rich. I guess I'll never do it. One of these days when I'm financially stable and I don't have to stress about anything. I get a little envious of the people that when we're at artist alleys, the people that have the full-time jobs. I get a little envious of it, because they don't stress as much as I stress about how much money they're making at the con, and they're so happy. They're like, oh, I covered table. And then they like skip away. And it's like, covered table? What? We are not out here to cover table. If we're covering table, I'll be at home. I probably shouldn't, to be honest, worry as much as I am about the line work on these trees, because this is like a hand-drawn map. I should be making it look hand-drawn. That's kind of what I should be doing. It shouldn't be crystal clear, crisp. Carlos says, I wasn't in dire need, but it is a huge help. Those are the people driving up those table rates and buying out the tables they want. Yeah, they are. That too. It's crazy. It is insane. Oh, there's my dog. Making sure I haven't forgot about him. It is hand-drawn, technically. Everything is hand-drawn. Carlos is attacked. I am so ready for one day when I get that random knock on my door, and it's going to be somebody from Animal Services, that they're like, we got an anonymous call from your neighbors. Apparently you're leaving your dog leashed up outside and he's whimpering and howling all day. I'm ready for it. Oh yeah, my neighbors called the cops, yep. And I live around a whole bunch of old people that have nothing better to do with their time. And they all have the perfectly, you know, manicured lawns, and, you know, they've all got that old Connecticut money, all retired. They're all nosy. With a capital N. Goddess of D's likes to get modded all the time. This is a family-friendly stream. Please refer from bullying language. Yeah, Ray. Well, yes. I just saw a thing, Ray, for some show that's happening like this weekend in Oklahoma. One of the artists I follow was saying, hey, if you're going to be at, I don't remember what the name of it was, if you're going to be at this show in Edmond? Is that right? Edmond, Oklahoma? There was definitely an OK. There was OK abbreviation. I was like, oh. Like, check out my work. Check out my table. I feel like I made that worse. Leave it like that, I guess. You grew up in Edmond and you should know, man. I was a pretty big artist. You know of any shows that are happening this weekend? I'm still convinced she just needs to get laid. She's such a jerk. Who, the dog or the neighbor? Who are you talking about? Both? She had Jake's car stickered because it was in front of my house without moving. Yeah, that's the kind of stuff that it's like, get a life. It's like, that's the kind of stuff. That's the kind of stuff where, like, your house is getting robbed. Your house is getting robbed, and they do nothing. You know what I'm saying? Your house is getting robbed, and your neighbors do nothing. And then you have, like, yeah, you have like, oh no, I've left my trash cans out for like 3 days after trash pickup, and then they're giving you the HOA notice. Which I don't own a house, so that doesn't matter. She's interfering unless something actually matters. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Amazing. I'm looking, Race. I'm looking. The only thing I can see is maybe heard on her. No. I could try to find it later, but it doesn't really matter. It doesn't really matter, to be honest. I just thought maybe you might have heard something. I'm also half expecting to go out there one time and he's just gone. That's what happened to me when I was a kid. My mother leashed up one of our dogs to do yard work and stuff, and it was fine. But then we went and grabbed some food, and so she left the dog leashed up while we went and got, like, honestly, it was like McDonald's. It was a quick trip. Like, we went and got some food, and we came back, and then the leash was just there. No dog. With like a note that was like taken to the animal control or something, because some neighbor was like just waiting. It's like, come on. Come on, what are we doing? And again, it's like you could be your house being broken into. And they're like, oh, because we're having friends over, because we're having company. being robbed. Do something. When I lived in my first apartment, my stereo got stolen out of my car. And my neighbor saw it happening and didn't do anything to stop it. Actually came over and said, after the fact, I saw the whole thing happen and even had a conversation with them. And I'm sorry, I thought you knew them. And I'm like, thanks. Wonderful. I tried to get into that for years, but they don't like me. Who could not like Funny Figs? Not what I call a huge show, though. Left at the Two Trees. If you've gone to the single, then Two Trees, you've gone too far. Yes. Yes. You've gone too far. Honestly, I shouldn't be taking this long. It's going to take me forever to do these coins. I shouldn't be worrying so much on these stupid trees. You're the nosy neighbor, Carlos? Carlos. No, Carlos! You're the nosy neighbor? Carlos. You know what you get, Carlos? You get this. That's what Carlos gets. Oh, I don't want to draw these coins. I am the very indifferent neighbor. I don't care what my neighbors are doing. I don't. They can do whatever they want. I don't care. If their house is on fire, am I going to go over there and let them say, hey, your house is on fire, you need help? Probably. Probably. I'm that person. I don't like acknowledging I have neighbors. Just leave me to socialize on Twitch. In-person people are too much. I don't mind in-person people. All right, here we go. I'm gonna fuse that to the... Yes. Oh, you know what? Let's save it. Shall we save? Fortune. Party of D's, let's a go go. Wake me up. See, Jake laughs because he's like, I'm super quiet. And my response is, yeah, until you know them, then you're a social butterfly. Ever since COVID, I've got like a max of 2 to 3 hours before I'm like, nope, I'm out. Let me go make sure the dog's just not tangled and choking himself. I'll be right back. I'll just leave it on the map. Thank you. He's fine. It makes me mad when he's howling for no reason. You got no reason to howl. Knock it off. He just doesn't want to be out there. Wait, I'm realizing the challenge redeems went away today, and I didn't even use one yesterday. The missed opportunity. I know. I was setting up the stream today, and I'm like, fortune. Because I knew today was going to be a long one. Because I was like, no matter what I come up with, because I kept thinking fortune in terms of money, in terms of gold. And I was like, whatever I draw is going to take forever. It's going to be coins. It's going to be treasure. It's going to be whatever. It's going to be a long one. And I was like, I don't want any redeems when I'm trying to do that. I don't know. These coins are looking oddly flat. Should I just, like, try to just draw them on my own? I feel like I should not do that. Maybe the top one. They're oddly looking like
flat. We'll just put one in here by the castle.
Yes, we don't go around altering my blast. Let Dr. Franklin go. Yes, I think so. Yes, the joyfulness is over.
Let's see. They're like too, yeah, it like makes it look flat for some reason. Oh, there's like no easy way to do this. There's no easy way to do this. Let me be my typical self and avoid it by doing some other things now. How about this one little spare coin that needs to be down here? There you are. Take care of you. Don't you worry. There you are. I guess I should figure out what to put on it, shouldn't I? I don't want any tangents. No tangents. They don't look like they have embossing on them. Yeah, they got nothing on them. Where's this stack? Here it is. See, like this line here also looks oddly wonked. Okay. I need another one of these. I need another one of these. Give me another one of these. And that one gets leaned up like this. It's gonna have to be a fusion of both the more precise elliptical tool ones and me drawing them, which is fine. I guess that's how it's supposed to be. I think I am comfortable taking this stack of coins here, copy and pasting it. You can usually get away with doing it one time, and then I'll flip it and put that one back here. Like that. You can do it once. Ray, good job on your Mayan ruins. Ray finished up his Mayan ruins project he was doing. Everybody. Someone's a pumpkin eater. You're a pumpkin eater, Carlos. You're a bottom burger bun. Look, I'll just change a couple little things about it, and it's totally different. Do you guys want to see Ray's Mayan ruins? I don't ask Ray. I just ask everyone else. Does everyone else want to see Ray's thing? Ray, I have not asked. I will not ask. Actually, two small pieces left, but the majority of the work is done. What I want to do is I want to do an extreme close-up on the faces that you did because they were funny. All right, guys, let's look at Ray's. Let's stop looking at what I'm doing because that's not that exciting. I want you to look at what Ray made. Ray did this. Whoops. He did this whole wall of Mayan ruins. You see this? You see this? Look at the craftsmanship. Look at the artistry. These little guys.
You did it. Drink a Dr. Pepper.
Good job, Ray. These guys, Donkey Kong Country Returns Biters. The itty bitty biters. I don't know if you ever played Donkey Kong Country Returns. But one of the levels, it's itty bitty biters is the level. And this is like the entry into it. And then there's these little creatures that are all over the level. And they look like this. So they got little cat noses. But when I looked at your thing, I was like, oh, that looks exactly like... This looks like that. Which I'm sure it all comes from the same kind of source material, you know? But that's my initial thought. I was like, oh, it's like the Donkey Kong Country level. Covers the whole apartment wall. It's a lot. Look what we got here. Let's take a look at these. I like this. I like the, I'm going to draw this real quick and no one's going to notice how messy it is, but it's going to blend in and no one will ever pick up on it. I picked up on it. Let's see. Got some stuff going on the walls. Look at the cracks. Look at these split tongues we got going on. That's gone. Be gentle. It looks great. It looks wonderful. Is this like real? Are these real plants like stuffed in here for like the facade, or is that like, I mean, is it real or are they like fake plants that were like just shoved in there for like to make it look like part of it? Look at this. Hey guys. The intense, unrequited critique. Intense! Ray critiques every line. I draw one line on the paper, and Ray's like, you sure about that? I draw one line, and he's like, interesting move.
I think I've improved on your methods a bit, too. I employed some chiaroscuro shading and...
I'll improve on your methods!
What?
Here's the other one. Here's the other picture. What is this big spot? Is this supposed to be like an entryway, a doorway? You take a photo in front of it? No, that's supposed to be. I love these faces. I love them. I love them. I think they're great. We got some white speckle on there. Or is that just like, is that accidental? Is that part of the photograph? It's only over here. Is that on purpose? The white flex. This one looks extra evil. You know the best part of this, Ray? Is that the different panels kind of adds to it. Like it's different rocks. This had to be a lot of paint. This had to be paint intensive. There's one head pointing the wrong way that my daughter did. Ooh. Where's Waldo? Not horrible, about 4 ounces of 3 different colors. I don't know how airbrush works. I just noticed, is this a skeleton? Who's just like hanging out? What's up? All right. Enough of that, this is not a funny fig stream. Airbrush comes in 2 ounce bottles. Each bottle is like $5. That's $5, though. You know what I mean? You know what I'm saying? Nice work, Ray. Ray, good job. Everybody, Ray, you did a good job.
Good job. You did it. Drink a Dr. Pepper.
Although, everybody, Ray is no longer drinking Dr. Pepper. He is watching his figure, okay?
It's probably the best drawing I've ever done.
Probably. All right, what else can I do besides drawing coins? What else can I do with my life besides drawing coins? Wood grain texture on the table? Sure. We're gonna do everything else but the coins. You know I'm gonna have to add some shine on that. I got to. Golden coins, we gotta have some shine. My absolute first thought, my absolute gut immediate first thought when I thought fortune was like a massive treasure room with like some evil guy sitting on a throne on top of it. And I'm like, dear Lord, do I not want to do that to myself? That was my instinctive first thought. I want you guys to know. Which, of course, I think is cool, but, you know. Reasonable? Who's to say? Who's to say? See, I go to a fortune cookie. It's really interesting because God Sadi said the same thing. Talking about, like, a fortune teller. I didn't think of that at all. I think of, like, money and, like, treasure. That's really interesting. Very, very interesting, I think. I do not want to do these coins. How do I always get... See what I mean? I get tangents all the time. Entirely by accident. But I get like an alarming number of them for some reason. I don't know why. Maybe I have the tangent curse. Curse of the tangents. Do I want to use a different brush for this? Maybe. Do I dare? I don't know if I dare. Fingerprint? Giant fingerprint? No. No, that's dumb. Let's just stick with what I'm doing. Don't need to be a hero. This one might be my, I keep waiting for my dud. This one might be my dud. I mean, I don't love this. I think it's fine. It's my first prompt that I'm not like, yeah, I like this. Not my accident, by desire not to do something that is next. Eyebrow has the tangent curse. The eyebrow, yes. If only there was a challenge to reinvigorate your artistic spirit. If only there was a month-long challenge to really just get those artistic muscles going, you know? Too bad. Maybe I should invent one day. So the one thing going for this one, though, that is kind of neat is the narrative. That it's like, oh, this is that same exact map that was in the other one. That's the thing that makes this cool, I think. If only there was an artistic challenge. Telling a little story with Inktober prompts would be kind of fun. That's what the guy does that created this. I don't know if you follow him. Jake Parker, I think is his name. He's the guy that owns the copyright. He created Inktober. All of his prompts work together. They're all one story. So like he did Toad, and it was a giant toad monster that his little character is like came across underground. And then the next prompt was bounce. So then the toad had, like, was attacking him and, like, had, like, ground-pounded the space in front of him, and it, like, pushed him back. Is the waifu's face on the back of this map? Let us tie them all together. Let's get it all together. The waifu's. I still don't technically even know what that means. It's like, lady? Attractive lady? Anime? Is this an anime thing? Is this part of that anime? That's what my dad used to say. All of my drawings were all part of that anime. All right. Whatever you say, Father. That is a lot of detail work for a hand-drawn map. Yeah, let's go into the pics. Into the pixels. I'll leave it at that. I've done like everything I can do except for the stupid coins. And I kind of still want to put something on the coin. I don't want it to just be blank. That's kind of lame. Okay. C copy paste. They stamp coins, copy and paste that. Yeah, oh yeah, for sure. I'll do one and then I'll copy and paste it, for sure. See, I was doing that, Ray, and it looks too weird. It looks too, something about the perspective is off. Maybe it's this bot. Let me try this. Let me take this. Something, this bottom one somehow, it's like not round enough or something. Okay, there's the coin. C, copy, paste, C. Start erasing lines because I'm getting confused. I don't know why. So see, this is what I'm talking about. I'm just copying and pasting it. That's all I'm doing. And this seems right. This seems flat. Like the perspectives don't match. Like this should be more. So I don't know. Will I keep doing this? Yeah, probably. Because otherwise it's gonna take me literally 10 hours and I don't have time for that. But it's just like, I don't understand. Is this like an optical illusion that's messing with my brain? I'm just copying and pasting. That's all I'm doing. But it, like, for some reason, it doesn't seem right. The bottom seems like it's flattening out as I'm doing it. You don't have a coin brush? It's like, you know there are some artists out there that got that. 100%. I'll just do what I did for the other stack. It's fine. It'll look fine if you just erase a few of the lines so they're more implied. Yes. Oops. What are we doing? You throw me off. Oh, really? I'm so confused. I'm so confused. I got so many layers going on. Okay, I need another one of these coins. You go over there and stay away. Stay away. There's that, and there's that. Yes. You guys go together. Yes. What is this? No. Why is that? What? What? I already made... Lord... I merged you guys together. Okay, there we go. Yes, 100% you can even choose the type of coin. I believe that. I don't know why I can never really make those work for me. I've seen some awesome stuff that artists have done with those type of brushes. I saw somebody do an entire battle. Like a war. Like a fantasy era war. And... I'm very disappointed. And they drew the whole thing with like a brush that just created bad guys. It was insane. It was like, all right, I'm gonna turn on my bad guy brush, and they just like swooped across the bottom and it just like randomly placed silhouettes of like people with swords and shields and spears and stuff like in battle. And they did like three different layers of it and just kind of changed the opacity of it each time. I was like, that, what, this is witchcraft. You're just showing me witchcraft is what's happening. And then they had a brush that was all like battle flags. It was crazy. How many times do I have to tell you to merge before you do it? I swear I merged those layers like 10 times. And then I kept moving it and it was like, nah, we're not merged. I'm like, what do you mean? What do you mean you're not merged? I merged you. Class, pay attention. If I have to tell you one more time. Oh, dang. See, and I did that again. I should not have deleted that. All right. Back, 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 back. Okay. All right. Ooh. Let's take this whole stack. Let's duplicate this whole stack. Boom. Let's flip it around. Boom. And we're going to put that here. Put that right there. We're going to go right there. Beautiful. Get rid of all this. Get rid of all this. No, don't get rid of that. Get rid of this, 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 this.
Hi, Kevin.
B-Habs is here, finally. About time you showed up. If I have to tell you one more time... Habs of the Bee. Habs of the Bee. Whoa. Easy. Easy. How is everyone? Everyone is... I don't know. I don't speak for everybody. How's everybody? How we doing? Can I just, like, straight up just copy all of these? Can I just do that? And then I'll erase the lines inside of them differently. That'll be the thing. They'll all be differently erased. But they will all come from the same source. How's Kevin doing? Kevin's miserable. But I'm here. Fighting for my life at work. Crystal Rosebear, hello. Fighting for your life at work is intense. That's intense. Today's prompt, B-Habs, is fortune. And what's interesting is I heard the word fortune, and I immediately thought of money and treasure. But Boba Laveau and Goddess of D's both immediately thought of fortune telling. I find that fascinating. Yes, it is. B-Habs, you also thought of fortune cookie? I'm going to be really interested to see what everybody draws on the internet, on the socials. Dang. Well. Well. Right. We got to use you again. You're up. You are patient zero. This stack of coins is patient zero. I'm just reusing the heck out of it. Because it's the one unaltered stack. I haven't erased any parts of it yet. B-Habs, I'm hungry, so I blame that. It could be a stack of cookies. It could, but it is not. It is a stack of coins. Can you imagine some treasure hunters are like, would you like some cookies while you look at this map? Sure. Hey, this doesn't look as bad now. Why did it look bad before? It definitely did, though. It looked bad before. I don't know why. It just did. Did I lower my expectations? That's probably it, wasn't it? Kevin, you think everything looks bad during the drawing. Yes. Some things stay bad. Some things. Not all the things. Some things do. Some things stay bad.
So you get nothing.
Nothing.
You lose.
Good day, sir. Did Brian update his social medias with his vampire persona? He is also a vampire now. Because I bit him. Because misery loves company. I was like, oh. Hello. You may also now be a creature of the night. You know what would be awesome? Hey, you know what would make me feel... Okay, you want to know what would make Kevin feel good? If all my artist friends, CRF underscore art room, funniest of figs, you guys should also draw yourselves as vampires and upload it for your social media profile. You still have like 3 weeks of October. Spread the Hinkle curse. If all my art friends... If you guys updated your stuff, like I bit you all and turned you all into vet, that would make me feel awesome. That would be cool. But don't do it just because I asked you to do it. All right? You do it because you want to do it. Spread the curse. Is this enough coins or should I add more coins? Can I just put little teeth on my logo? That would be... insanely amazing, Ray. You would get a pass. Ray gets a pass for doing that. You just slap. No, Ray, you need to Photoshop the most dollar store basic brand chompy teeth. Just straight up, don't even correct the angle. Just copy, paste, put it on your logo. Vampire, plastic vampire teeth. Done. Done. I probably could do that. I don't pretend to be an artist. Everybody should be a vampire now. This is enough coins. Yeah? Yeah, that's enough coins. Let's turn off that layer. What if Ray takes a picture of a fig and adds a cartoon face? See, those aren't the figs, though, that Ray is referring to. You may think he is like a connoisseur of the figs. No. Not quite. Look at all those coins. But yeah, if you guys wanted to make me feel loved, everybody should be a vampire now. Where did the layer go that I drew the wood? Oh, there it is. Where did the wood texture go? See, that's when Carlo stopped talking. Oh, there's an ask? Goodbye. Can I make a Dr. Pepper vampire? Funny. I didn't think that was the figs he refers to, but I thought it'd be funny. I mean, that's fair. It would be funny. Raise the funniest of figs. Okay, all right. Boy howdy, a lot of layers now. Do I just start merging them all together? I guess so. Okay, I'll keep that like that. I wanna clean up. Time for cleanup. Some of these, and a couple of these, and some of these. Not like funny, haha. Funny like. So speaking of funny, haha. I watched some more of those TikToks, Ray, from that caricature company. I thought that was all one person doing those, like, insanely slightly offensive caricatures. It's not. It's the whole brand because they showed multiple artists, male, female, just different artists all making slightly offensive portraits of people, and that's incredible. I love it. I love that they're all encouraged to do it. I thought it was one person. Funny, like, don't talk to that guy. He's talking to the railing on the subway. BMs, Kevin, if I drew a vampire bee, that's kind of, all right, funny. Entirely on my own, and send you a picture. Do you promise not to make fun of my drawing ability? No. But I'd love to see it. I can't, that's not a promise I can make. But I'd love to see it.
We'll just put one in here by the cast.
Yes, don't go around altering liable artwork, Dr. Franklin Gall. Yes, I think so. Yes, the joyfulness is over.
I can't make that promise. But that'd be funny. A vampire bee. That would not be BMs. So I'm going around and I'm fixing all these little stuff on the angles on the sides here first, and then I'm gonna go and erase. Crystal Rosebear using some hard-earned exposure bucks to resurrect Zombie Hink from the grave. Thank you very much. Set the timer. 15 minutes. There we are.
Oh no!
Oh yes! I'm still really excited when you guys finally unlock Robo Hink. You see this? Look at the thing up here. Look. Look, 83%. Look how close it is. Look how close we are to Robo Hink. We're so close. It's actually kind of obtainable. There's a lot of Hinks we need. But the thing about Robo Hink is that Robo Hink is ready to roll. He's just waiting. Okay, I'm gonna duplicate this entire layer in case I mess this up, because there's a high probability I will. All right. Can I do maybe some action like this? Ooh, 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 yeah, ooh, ooh, ooh. 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 Panda's sneaking in. So oh! Yummy, yummy, looks so good. Hey. Yummy, yummy, looks so good. Yummy, yummy, looks so good. Yummy, yummy, looks so good. Nice, Ray. You guys are finally learning. And look, B-Habs tried to do it too. You guys are learning. Love it. Love it. Love it. Thanks for stopping by, Panda. I hope work is being... I hope you're not fighting for your life at work. That's going to be our gauge. On a scale of fighting for your life and where do we land? I will forever be incredibly grateful anytime Crystal Rosebear is here, because I know she's fighting for her life at work. Like, dang. That's appreciation. That is appreciation. You're making it livable. Well, you know, I try. I am so grateful for your lives. I'm awesome that you guys enjoy it. I feel rewarded. Gonna be very sad in January. What happens in January? Are you one of those? You one of those people that thinks I'm stopping all live streaming? Are you a Matt Elder? Oh, you're probably right. I probably am taking a break in January. To be honest, I probably am. I probably am taking it. I don't think I might have mentioned that. I haven't, like, properly planned that yet, but I probably will. I did that last year. I didn't stream at all last January. It was a nice kind of break. I probably should, though. I think I mentioned that casually on a stream. I was like, eh, I'll probably take a break in January. But I hadn't locked it in. We'll see. We'll see how things land. Have you determined the date of the last... No, I haven't looked at the calendar yet. The major thing is I need to look at scout dates. I need to see when, like, scout stuff is gonna stop streams from happening. And I need to look at the holidays. I'm trying to get through October is what I'm trying. I'm trying to get through October first before I dedicate the time for that. So the one thing I decided is that I'm gonna skip every other week. So like there's no doodle stream this week. There'll be one next Thursday. Because last Thursday was actually a little too much for me. I know you may be asking yourself, what do you mean, Kevin? How was that too much for you? 7-hour live stream in a day? What do you mean? I know. Crazy. that one was too much for me. So every other week for dual streams in October. That's for sure. And then I need to look at the calendar. But I'll make sure everyone has ample notice. And then, you're gonna miss me when I'm gone. Everyone's gonna be like, man, really should have tuned into one of those. Yeah, you really should have. Really should have. Considering I was not there for most of it, it should have been a great stream. Last Thursday, yeah, it was intense. Because last Thursday I did the golden prompt, which was a 5-hour stream. And then I did, just a couple hours later, the 3-hour doodle stream. I was cooked. Fried. And I even thought about it before I started. I was like, man, I really shouldn't be doing this. I should cancel. But I didn't want to do it. I didn't want to let the people down. But then I had time. And I was like, okay, now I've got time to think. And yeah, I think I'm not going to do it next time. How do these look? These look pretty good, right? This looks fine. You smell bacon? Me? Because I was crispy bacon, man? There was one day, I hear my dog yelling again. There was one day last week where my dog was howling and I was like, ugh, let me go look. And there was actually a gigantic dog that was from my neighbor that was messing with him. Not in a mean way, just big dog trying to be playful with tiny, tiny, tiny dog, and tiny dogs don't ever like that. You know how it is. I'm trying to pick up if it's that type of whimper. That type of howl. It's a different type. Support the people. So you got one more thing to do for that Mayan thing, Ray, and then you're done? Then you're donezo with it? Didn't you say there's like Indiana Jones or something's going on there, right? Kind of recall something along those lines. Skeleton we dressed as Indy. Amazing. Amazing. Throw me the idol. Is it like super selfish of me to like jump into the artist Discord server and be like, hey, art friends, can you all draw yourself as vampires? It make me feel better. All right, bye. And then just leave? I feel like that's probably not. It would be cool, but I don't want to press the issue. But that would be kind of awesome. That would be kind of amazing to be like, all my friends are vampires. I've infected the whole thing. Oh, everybody. But I know everyone's doing a million things and everyone's busy. Everyone's busy and everyone's got stuff they're dealing with. Artists love jumping on a bandwagon for no discernible reason. See Inktober. Bab says, I had VTuber suggested channels popping up here, and I blame you, Kevin. Really? Nice. Sometimes they're fun. Sometimes they're highly inappropriate. But sometimes they're fun. Adding a little bit more detail work in here. Crystal Rosebear, I would definitely draw something. That's awesome. That's awesome. Warms my heart. My cold, dead heart. Is that enough? Have I done enough? This seems really off on this one. For some reason, this line seems like it's in a totally wrong spot. Same thing on here, I guess. I don't know how I did that. Somehow I did that.
Keep them waiting any longer.
I'm so excited about
welcome to art class.
Oh, isn't this cooking? Sorry.
Captain Seb coming back in for another raid. What's up, man? How you doing? Welcome back to my little corner of the internet. How was your stream? I'm drawing an endless number of coins. Oh, great. And I did it on the wrong layer, too. Love it. Love to see it. Love to see it. I guess I might as well just merge it all together now. Now it's... We're way too far under the weeds now. It's all just getting merged. Merge. It's all merged. My stream was good. I was playing Hunt. Took lots of players out. I have no idea what that is, but that's cool. All right, time is up. So thank you again, Chris Rosebear, for your hard-earned exposure bucks. I will return to my vampiric form. Okay, so we do need to put something on these coins. They can't be blank. They cannot be blank. Wow. way too much of a cop-out. Some people call it the most dangerous game, where you physically hunt down your viewers in real life. Oh. Oh. Thanks for raiding in, man. Infuriating. Infuriating. Unexpected. What movie was that from? Somebody was fighting somebody, and then they were much better than they should have been. And the character's like, unexpected. I can't remember. You scoff, but it gets great metrics. Killing people in real life? It's the Hunger Games. They're doing another Hunger Games, aren't they? It's like a prequel. Already done. I live in the hyperbolic time chamber. Time moves in a different orientation for me. I did watch the first episode of Loki because that was like the last Marvel thing I enjoyed watching. And it was okay. The thing is that I can't shake though, even with Loki, even me loving Loki, the thing I can't shake about it is that like I don't feel like any of it means anything anymore. And I'm like, this is fun, but it doesn't mean anything. Could have sworn I saw it on a streaming service. Really? Oh, it's next month. Look at you, Ray, trying to make me question my own sanity. There are four lights, Ray. Four lights. There are four lights. Two plus two equals five. Get out of here. All right, we gotta adjust this one a little bit. Like that. We also need to rotate it a little bit, it looks like, somehow, magically. Because somehow I changed that. Okay. Let's do another one. You come over here. Ooh, so that one got scaled. Scale it down. Like that. And like that. A little bit more. It needs to get rotated a little. There are four lights. Okay. duplicate that. Now let's take it over here. Ooh, that one's good because I don't have to do anything. Perfect. It's already ready to roll. All right, good. Good, good, good. Do it again. Oop, up here. Whoa. Oops, how did I do that? It's starting to mess with the opacity. Okay, good. Do it again. Are we having a good time? Are we enjoying watching this part? This is super, super mundane. It'll look good, though, when it's done. I don't hate it anymore. Hey, good news. I don't hate it anymore. All right. Let's see. Good news, everyone. I don't hate it anymore. I do tend to hate a lot of my stuff off the bat. The important thing is I push through it. I push through it. I don't typically quit. But I do often think it looks ugly. I wish I could tell you why. I don't know. We're getting there. We got a lot of tops of coins to put these on. Yeah, that looks good. Keep on chugging along. All right, another one over here. Okay. And another one over here. Yes. No, I think that's too much. All right.
Fortune favors the bold.
That's a brand quote from somebody. What is that from? It's probably like a betting service. Reed is back with 10 more bits. Did you get your vehicle? Look at all these coins, Reed. Look how many coins I've drawn. Look at this map. Look at these jewels. I'm in the process of putting these little ridges on the top of the coins here. That extra, just that little extra bit.
Oh, Jesus! Oh, God! Oh, oh, Jesus, God! Oh, Mary, Mother of Jesus, Jesus of Nazareth!
No, that's not the reaction. Let me turn this one on the side. Yoop. Oh, I scaled this one down. I see.
Looks so
good.
Yummy, yummy. Looks so good.
Hey.
Yummy, yummy. Looks so good. Yummy, yummy. Looks so good. Yummy, yummy. Looks so good.
There we go. Acceptable. All right. Let me merge all of these. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 13 levels. 13 layers of tops of coins. Now, the next question is, do I put something else on this? Like, do I put a portrait? Like, a portrait of somebody? Because the thing is, if I do that, and then I copy and paste it, I can only do this probably for, like, half of these. And then the other half, I'd have to change to a different orientation. Just do a square. Like classic fantasy. Avatar money style. Asian inspired money style. I was trying to do a square like in the... That is your square. I was trying to do a square in the perspective. I mean, it'd be like... depending on which angle you're looking at it. Right? I don't know. What do I want to do? What do I want to do? Here, let's skip for a second. Let's just skip. Let's put a pin in that. And let's throw some halftones. I know the table is going to be halftone. That's easy. Table is going to be halftone.
I think I've improved on your methods a bit, too. I employed some chiaroscuro shading and...
I'll improve on your methods!
What?! That's so interesting. I feel like most of you guys, when you heard Fortune, thought of Fortune Teller first. Most of you. If not all of you. Ray, what was your first... I know you're completely tainted now, because now you've seen me drawing and we've talked about this. Did you think of money, or did you think of fortune telling? What was your initial thought? See, this is how you know who's in desolate condition. This is how we know who's thinking of money first. I'm thinking of money, sir. Yes. It's a commentary on society. I immediately thought of money. Like, fortune telling didn't even cross my mind until someone said it. I was like, oh, yeah, fortune. Fortune telling. That's right. Fortune telling. Oh yeah, that's right. How long has this been going on? 3 hours? Perfect. Perfect. Because this is just about done. I'm thinking I may not put anything on the coins, actually. Partly just to finish this, but partly because I can't think of anything and I don't necessarily want to do a square. I don't really want to go with the Asian influence. My gut is like a portrait, but I don't want to do that. That's too much work. I'm not trying to be a hero. maybe no. We'll see. Just under 3 hours. A triangle. Fortune would be money. As we know, you are terrible about fortune-telling your future. Yes, I am. Where's my light source? Crystals, jewels, gems. What does it mean? What does it mean? Those are very important to my story, actually. Extremely, extremely important. I guess I'll do a little bit on some of these coins that are kind of in the background. And lurking for the next meeting. Well, thanks for hanging out. I'll probably be done by the time you're done. There's not much left of this. Not much left to this. At all. Dishes! Yep. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yes. I think that might be it. I'll add some, like, shines and stuff. Here and here. And here, probably. So, this is Fortune. The background's gonna be black. I'll do the final save out and crop. Just as soon as the stream's over. So it'll go up on socials in 15, 20 minutes. Save it. I'm gonna call it. I'm gonna call it on this one. So let's do this together because this is my favorite thing to do. This is my favorite thing to do. This is my favorite part of this. Boom! Look at that. A third of the way done. A third of the way done, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for hanging out with me. Today's prompt was fortune. I thought of money, coins.
Good job. You did it.
Stuff
drink
like that.
Drink a Dr. Pepper.
Thank you, Ray. And B-Habs. And Ray. Let's get out of here. Let's get out of here. Let's see. Please let there be somebody I can raid. I don't want to go searching. Cloud Fluff U is doing some testing and drawing some things in perspective. Let's just go say hi to Cloud Fluff U. How about that? Let's just do
that. It's probably the best drawing I've ever done.
I don't know how long their stream's going to last because it looks like they're just testing, but I follow them already, so easy. Easy peasy. If you want to hang out with me and say hi, that'd be cool. Drop a follow. I'm sure they'd appreciate it. Otherwise, have a wonderful rest of your day. Have a wonderful, rest of your Tuesday. And I'll see you guys tomorrow for another Inktober. And you will watch my slow descent into madness continue one more day. All right. Take care, everybody. See you later.